Hey, it's Chris Greenwood, also known as Manifest, author of the book From Red to Black, A Short Journey from Debt to Liberty. I've really enjoyed this video series with you. And again, if you haven't got a free copy of this, make sure you click the link below this video or go to manifest.com to get a copy. And today we're going to be talking about ways to increase your income. You know, for getting out of debt and building wealth, you know, it's one thing to cut expenses, which is great, and I'm hoping when you went through your budget in the last video and built a budget to see how much cash flow you have coming in, I'm hoping when you went through your statements that you found some things like, man, I need to cut that, or I can cut that, or there's like a membership or something that, you know, you realize that like, man, I don't need to be paying that much, or there's an insurance that you negotiated, or maybe you negotiated a different rate on your mortgage, anything to bring those expenses down. But what I really love is increasing your income. And so I wanted to go over a few ideas to increase your income so that you can have more money to pay down any debt, build wealth, and invest in your dream. You know what I'm saying? So the first idea I have for you, and this is of course if you, you know, work a job, is can you get more hours? Can you get extra hours? Can you show up earlier? Can you stay later? Can you talk to your boss and say, hey, can I get a few extra hours? Can you talk to some of your other friends that work there and say, hey, if you're ever thinking of, you know, chopping your hours, or you need, you know, someone to take your spot, I'd love to. Can you see how you can add more value at work so that your boss, your manager is noticing, you know, and then you can get that time and a half or that extra pay if they offer that at your employment area. Okay, but increase those hours, okay? The second thing is, can you get a second job? You know, maybe you're only working part-time, or maybe you're only getting a certain amount of hours at work, and if they won't give you more hours, can you get a second job on the weekends or at nights where you can get that income up, all right? And I wanna encourage you, when you're getting a job, you know, don't always just look at how much they're paying you. You know, what connections can you build? What can you learn there? Who can you become by being there and surround yourself with people that'll cause you to stretch, grow, and earn more money? Because you want to surround yourself with people, not only that, you know, just so you can get that paycheck, but people that are going to challenge you to grow and be in a business, be in something that you believe in that is making change, where you can grow and learn skills so that you can eventually charge more. All right, because that's one of the other things too, is that look, you know, if you want to make more, you need to increase your value, right? And how can you increase your value? By learning and developing skills, getting the know-how, getting the knowledge, getting the experience, getting the connections, working with people, all right? Number three is, and this is what I basically said, is learn new skills to pay the bills. And one of the best ways to increase your income is learning these new skills so you can charge more. Maybe you learn how to edit videos. Maybe you learn graphic design. Maybe you learn, you know, how to shoot videos, take photos. Maybe you learn a skill on with mechanics, with cars. Just something where you learn a new skill that you can charge more for your service because you know how to do that now. It's kind of like another asset in your pocket there so that you can charge more. You know, I didn't know how to do Facebook ads for a long time, so I started to learn how to run marketing and advertising, and so I was able to charge more. Then I decided to learn how to run YouTube ads and how to market and how to sell. And these were skills that I started to learn that people eventually wanted to pay me to learn because I got good at them. And so don't just learn this stuff, you know, become great at it. Become great at it, all right? So that's some stuff to think about. And then the last one here, number four, there's actually six, but we're just gonna cover four right now, is can you start a side business? Can you start a side hustle? Maybe it's with your spouse. Maybe it's with your girlfriend. You know, there's a story of this couple in our church who, this lady there, she would make these amazing custom cakes for birthdays and special events. And word started to travel and she started to get booked and, you know, she started to get more business. And this company just started to grow to the point her husband had to leave his job and now they work on this business together. You know, is there something that you and your spouse can do? You know, I know couples that, you know, do wedding photography together and stuff like that, and they just, they're a team. They both shoot, or one shoots, the other person edits, and then they travel around. You know, when me and my wife got married, we started our business together with music and ministry, and, you know, she would help book shows, she'd run the merch table, and, you know, now she even helps me write songs and does all kinds of stuff, helps me, you know, we release books and stuff together, but we came together and we built this business. And let me just tell you something really powerful about that and why a three-corded strand is not easily broken. And when you get on the same page as your spouse regarding money, business, and having a dream, you've got you, you've got God, you've got your spouse. but then you, that's a three-chorded strand, but then you have your dream, you have your purpose wrapped up in that, that's a four-chorded strand, you know what I'm saying? And then you're really powerful and you're unstoppable because you and your wife are on the same page, you got God in the middle of it, right? And if he's for you, who could be against you? But then you've got purpose and you've got clarity. And sometimes that takes some time to pray. And say, God, you know, what would you call me to do? You know, Jeremiah 33:3 says, call on me and I'll tell you those things that you do not know. And so I believe that God, you know, is knocking on the door of your heart right now. You know, there's something stirring in your heart. You know you're called to something great. You know you've got something on the inside of you that is just wanting to get out so badly. But maybe you've let fear, maybe you've let insecurity stop you. Maybe you think that, well, people are going to be like, oh, who do you think you are trying to, you know, go after wealth or go after your dream? Let me tell you why critics criticize you. And it's because when you take action and you start going after your dream, it shines a light on their cowardice. You know, critics love to criticize that which they wish they had the courage to do. And if you want to smash fear in the face, do that which you're afraid to do, and the death of fear is certain. Just keep doing it afraid. You know, you don't have to always be strong and courageous. Sometimes you just got to just get up and do it and punch fear in the face. And so I want to encourage you to step out for your dreams. Go for this thing. I know you're called to wealth. I know you're called to greatness, but you've got to take that step of faith, my friend. Action fuels success. Joshua 1:8 says, be strong and courageous. Be strong and courageous. So I hope that this video series has encouraged you. Again, I'll remind you, make sure you pick up a copy From Red to Black, A Short Journey from Debt to Liberty, to help you grow. And when you do get the book, you'll also get an opportunity to get the VIP Masterclass, where me and my wife are actually teaching you how to build wealth, how to get out of debt, how to start a business and be successful, bring money into the kingdom and make an impact in this world, so that you can be mission-minded and not always money-minded. I gotta pay the bills. You can be like, yo, I got that figured out now. Now I'm all about impact, you know, and that's what I'm talking about here. So this is Chris Greenwood, also known as Manifest, and I want to remind you that a fighter isn't someone who never fails. A fighter is someone who never quits.